Kia ora. This is a great little flash simulation that you can use to explore the relationship between the solubility product constant and the amount of or the concentration of ions that will dissolve in the solution. So the first thing you need to do is compare the type of salt. So this is a silver bromide, an AB salt, and so is a calcium carbonate salt. So I can compare these two KSP values, or KS values as we do here in New Zealand. Lead chloride and lead and iron hydroxide are AB2 salts, so we cannot compare the KS values with the first two, but we can compare them between each other. So if I look at the first one, the silver bromide and calcium carbonate, look at the different values, which one is bigger, which one will dissolve more. So let's try it out. So we're going to react. Notice that in the beginning, we didn't have any silver ions or bromide ions in solution. And eventually, as the silver bromide dissolved, I got more and more silver and bromide ions until it reached an equilibrium. And I have equal amounts of silver and bromide ions. I don't have more of one than the other because I have one silver bromide reacting to form one silver ion and one bromide ion. Be aware that the y-axis does change in value, so don't just look at the height of the graph, because when we look at the calcium carbonate, we're going to see a very similar graph, but the values here will be different. So this is 5.74 times 10 to the minus 7. If I now look at the calcium carbonate, it looks as though the same amount has dissolved, but notice that the y-axis now goes to 10 to the minus 4. And so we have a lot more that's dissolved. It's 6.16 times 10 to the minus 5. 10 to the minus 5 is a much bigger value than 10 to the minus 7. So calcium carbonate is more soluble and it has a bigger KS value. Let's compare the AB2 salts. So we can look at lead chloride. And notice what happens here. We don't have the same amount of ions because every one lead chloride forms one lead 2 plus ion and 2 chloride ions. So we have twice the amount of chloride ions in solution when we try and dissolve lead chloride in water. Again, it doesn't look as though much has dissolved, but the y-axis is 0.1, so this is quite soluble, 0.0162 moles per liter. A fairly soluble salt, but it's still considered sparingly soluble. Compared to iron hydroxide, if I react it, it looks as though it's much more soluble, but please look at the y-axis. It's 10 to the minus 5, so we don't have very much dissolved, but you will see the pattern of twice the amount of hydroxide formed to iron. And for fun, you can explore what happens when we have an AB3 salt. Now, in the next lesson, you will be doing calculations. In other words, if you're given a solubility product, can you calculate the solubility? In other words, how much will dissolve? What is the concentration of the ions in solution? So if you get given that, will you end up with answers like this? Or the other way around, if I give you the solubility and I say how much has dissolved, would you be able to work out the KS value? So in the next lesson, you can go back to the simulation and do the calculations and see if you get the right answer. Kia ora.